Hey everyone, I'm back with another suspension comparison video, this time looking at two long travel 29ers, the Specialized Enduro and YT Capra 29. Both of these bikes are running a 4-bar horst link suspension design and feature 170mm of front travel. Out back is 170mm of rear travel on the Enduro and 160mm of rear travel on the Capra Pro 29 I'll be looking at. There is the option of 170mm rear on the Capra Pro Race 29 model, but that might be out of the budget for many riders. As always, the analysis will begin by looking at how the two bikes react under braking and acceleration. There's a link in the top right to look at the theory of these two concepts if you need more info about them. Looking at the Specialized Enduro, you'll notice an almost flat anti-rise graph at around 45% throughout its travel, similar to the Scott Ransom. Switching over to the YT Capra 29, you'll notice a similar trend with anti-rise values that hover around 50%. As such, these suspensions will be very active under braking, as braking forces are mostly decoupled from the suspension movement. This positive does mean, however, that these bikes won't remain as level and composed under braking as other designs, and will allow the mass transfer of the rider forward that will seek to extend the rear suspension. However, given the gravity focus of the Enduro and Capra, it's not surprising to see these values. In case you're wondering, a bike that will remain more level under braking would be the Santa Cruz Megatower, which has anti-rise that starts around 90% and slowly decreases to around 60% at half travel. When comparing anti-squat values between the two bikes, you'll notice that they differ quite significantly. The Specialized Enduro has anti-squat values that hover around 110 for most of its travel, and even increase slightly deep in its travel. As such, it's going to pedal very efficiently with no pedal bob, but it also means that the suspension might suffer from being less active deeper in the travel due to chain force interference, and have higher pedal kickback, which I'll touch on later. The YT Capra bike comparison has decreasing anti-squat values, which begin around 110%, reach 70% at half travel, and around 15% at full travel. As such, you might need to use the climb switch on the Capra a bit more to prevent some pedal bob deeper in the travel. It also does mean, however, that this suspension will be more active deep in its travel when compared to the Enduro, Megatower, and Ransom, the latter two that fall somewhere between the Enduro and Capra in terms of pedal efficiency. Given the gravity focus of these two bikes, it's important to look at the kinematics and leverage ratio in particular to see how they'll react when they're pointed downhill and actually start using up all of their travel. Looking first at the Specialized Enduro, you'll notice a linearly decreasing leverage ratio from 3.4 to 2.6, which is almost identical to that of the Santa Cruz Megatower. This is going to lead to very good bottom-out support without sacrificing small bump compliance. This also means that heavier riders might need to run really high pressures in the air shock, and also gives people the option to run a coil shock if they desire. When looking at the YT Capra 29, you'll notice one of the most progressive leverage ratios of any bike I've looked at, and possibly of any enduro bike out there. While progressivity is a good thing, too much of it is likely to lead to some problems with bike setup and suspension feel for the average rider. Lots of progression in the frame design, combined with an air shock setup with 30% sag, is likely to lead to the suspension getting harsh and stiff very quickly, and likely you'll never use full travel. In order to use full travel, you'd have to run higher sag numbers, closer to 35 or 40%, but this will lead to numerous problems, including missing out on the small bump sensitivity early in the travel, losing some of your travel to sag, and lowering your bottom bracket, so pedal strikes become a concern. Has anyone experienced this with the Capra 29? If we combine the leverage ratio with the spring rate of the shock, the high progressivity of the Capra becomes evident. A good way to envision my statement about sag is to match the forces exerted by the two suspensions. By lowering the pressure in the Capra shock such that the maximum force of both is the same, and thus one is likely to be able to use full travel on both bikes, one can see why the higher sag is required to match the sag force prior to lowering the pressure, which is set to counteract the rider weight. When comparing the wheel path and chain growth of the Enduro and Capra 29, the high pedal kickback of the Enduro I mentioned earlier becomes evident by both the higher chain growth and more rearward wheel path. The chain growth for the Enduro is just over 30mm or 6.8%, the most of any bike I've looked at. The Capra by comparison only has a chain growth of 21.7mm or 5%. So what is my conclusion about these two long travel 29ers, and are you better off saving money by going with a direct-to-consumer YT? Firstly, the low anti-rise of both bikes will result in active braking, but also allow pitching forward of the bike while braking due to mass transfer. The active braking, however, likely outweighs the disadvantages for these gravity-orientated bikes. Secondly, the anti-squat values of the Enduro being around 110% means that it'll have no pedal bob and very efficient pedaling, but a slightly less supple suspension deep in its travel compared with the more active suspension of the Capra 29, whose anti-squat values decrease quite significantly throughout its travel. As a result of this though, the Capra will suffer from some pedal bob mid-travel. Thirdly, the kinematics of the Enduro is progressive just the right amount in my opinion, compared with the slightly excessive progressivity of the Capra 29. The really highly progressive leverage ratio of the Capra is likely to lead to setup issues with an air shock, and one might be better off with a coil shock. Fourth, the high chain growth of the Enduro is going to cause some more pedal kickback, or will hinder the suspension slightly if one holds the pedal level while descending. The Capra 29, by comparison, has a relatively low chain growth, even lower than the Mega Tower and Ransom I looked at previously, and thus lower pedal kickback. Finally, is it worth saving a few bucks and going with the direct-to-consumer brand? In my opinion, no. You're better off going with the Enduro, or actually the Mega Tower or the Ransom, although I'd love feedback from those who own a Capra 29 to know if I'm correct in my opinions, which are based purely on the analysis of it. Thanks again for joining me and hope you enjoyed this video. If you like what I'm doing on this channel, please make sure to subscribe and like the video. And remember, if you want to be part of the recurring polls to vote on which bike to look at next, make sure to head over to my Patreon page using the link down below. Until next time, happy trails!